in this tutorial I'll be showing you how to make the basic rows. Now as you can see at the end here, we've got different stages as they go along. So we start off with either, just move this to the side a little bit, the basic ball, polystyrene ball, or we have the bud. When I first started making roses, I used to use these a lot, but now I always, is because I do more wedding cakes, I want the roses to be that little bit bigger than what I would normally do on a standard birthday cake. So I'm going to show you both ways how to do this. And that, what you will need obviously is your flower model in place. As you can see, I use Renshaw or I use a white platinum paste. This is really, really good because you can roll it super thin and it doesn't dry out whilst you're working on it. But for today's ones, I have used Renshaw, and as you can see, it's a lovely pink. And I have used the, Flamingo Pink by Sugar Flare, which is a gorgeous pink here, as you can see. We also have the set of cutters. I've got a couple sets here. These ones I got from Kit Box, as you can see, is a large set. And these one are the David Austin Rose, which I use a lot for the wedding cakes. Again, these I purchased from America, but we're using these ones today. So to get your basic shape of your rose to start with, grab a bit of paste, let's warm it up. How big you want these to be. Just roll it in between your hands like so, as you can see, and then use this part of your hand here, and you're working on the front half, not the back. So you're going to be giving it the top of the tip, as you can see here, and the bottom. So all you're doing is rolling it like so. So again, I'll show you. Roll it around. And then you've got your paste here, to gently roll it round and forms that. And it doesn't have to be perfect because it's going to be covered. And then just insert your cocktail stick like so. And there you have the starters. Now these I'd leave to dry for 24 hours before I started adding the layers on them. Okay, so there's that one there. If you're going to use one of the polystyrene balls, I get these from Amazon and they come in a big pack, as you can see, multi sizes, because we do all sorts of sizes for flowers and what have you. So this is a smaller one, a bit of icing, just dab it with some edible glue. Onto your ball, making sure that you are quite central to it. Then you grab one of your tools. Start of it, so you can see the difference in the sizes. Again, I'd leave that for 24 hours. Need them, so I put these aside. Then, as you can see, this is the one I did yesterday, which is ready for me to use. So, grab some paste. It does depend on the size of your flower that you're starting with, what petal cutter you're going to be using. A little bit ahead of myself, just dust it a bit lightly with cornflour. Just got that. I'm going to keep turning this so it doesn't stick to your board, especially in the warmer weather that we're having at the moment. It's very, very muggy. These little plastic sheets, it's just a like an A, well, it's bigger than an A4, should I say. It's just to protect this. Grab your foam pad, and on the first rows we have here, you'll need, you've got the first layer, as you can see here, then you have two. So you want to be cutting out three to begin with. Grab your ball tool, I always use the fat end. This is the first one that you're going to be doing. So you just stretch like so. Put a knife, just flip it over. Just around the outside of this, these two. Cover the first one and then just down the sides of the other two, like so. So this is the one that we had dried from yesterday. So just place it onto your piece like so, then bring it round, stick it down, and bring this right round. So that's your first one, and then the second two. Where you have this join here, that's where you want to be placing your first petal, like that, and then just gently round like so, and then this one goes opposite it. Again, tucking that bit in here, like that, and then this can come round like so. Make sure it's tucked in. And there you have your second layer, as you can see. So we're going to be working on this layer now. So once that has dried for a little bit, you do another three. Working on this, you can see how bigger it is from when you first cut it out. So making sure that the edges are nice and fine. So, that. Again, flip them over. Edges, so it's kind of forming a V. So you grab this. Again, you want to start in here, like that. So just tuck that in around like so. The other one tucked in, making sure that you're getting it the same height as your petal. You don't want to be applying it down here or too much up there. Get that back on. Tuck that in. And tucking it down the bottom. Tuck that in. Sorry about the noise, it's my fridge. Put that round. Sure you attach it down the bottom as well, not just these side bits. I'm not too worried about that because the petals are going to be getting bigger. So where you see a little bit of a lump, just use your brush or your tools, doesn't matter which you use because it's going to do the same job. And that's your next layer done. So this is what we use for the first few layers, and we're going to go to the bigger one, the next layer. So again, as you can see, we need three. Same sort of thing we were doing before around the outside. time. Just want to bring it over a little bit. Not too much. It's enough for like that to begin with. Bring it over. Again at the join. Bring it round and seal. Sure that you're using your fingers to make sure it's all tucked in underneath. So that's the next layer. And the final layer, again, you go up. As you can see, I've used three sizes. If you want to give it more layers, you can go up to the next size. So we need to have some of these. So we need five of these. The ball tool again, and the edges. If you want to do it a bit more that we have, very gently. Now if you struggle using your fingers and your thumbs, well, you can get either a skewer, or I use a cocktail stick, and just gently pull it over. Too heavy-handed if you're using this, because you don't want it to squash the petal on the other side. As you can see, I'm tucking it down the bottom so I can bring it down just a little bit more. And because this flower paste, you know, sets quite quickly, you don't have to put it into, sometimes I'll shape them and put them into one of these trays here, but they set quite quickly with here, even in this weather. So all you do, don't worry about your nail pencils, just making sure you've got it nice and perfectly tucked in there. And if need be, you want to give it a little bit more movement. And there you have your rose. Sometimes you need five, sometimes you need six. So I'm going to do six. Once you get going with these, you will have them all made up. As anything, I can normally have this covered with petals ready to roll, so it doesn't take too long once you know what you're doing. Now when the rose gets to be bigger, I tend to turn it upside down when I'm adding these layers. and this one round it. Need six. Always best to have more than what you need than less. Because then you've got to put your rows down and start over again. So again, just shape it if required. Now as you can see, they're starting to flop down. So what I do is I end up bending the wire and hanging it over one of the metal shelves I've got, or place it upside down like so and just rest it. Because this was done yesterday, it's nice and set. You can just rest it upside down so that your petals aren't going to be moving. And again, you can just give that a few hours and then you can just lift it off and it should be set. So there you have. Basic rose.